Welcome back to the
Premium Lounge.
I'm your host, DC, and this is my co-host,
Devin.
Yes, sir.
Wow, there's no shade, no member.
No shade.
Don't worry.
So if you're looking at me right now, and I don't know if you can really like zoom in, because I know most of you guys, you know, with the new Apple technology, the new iPhone technology, you can zoom into videos now. Don't look at my face, but it is No Shave November. So, you know, shout out to the men out there that's doing No Shave November. But talking premium, man. So last episode, we got you guys to vote on two questions. Of course.
You know who won? You already know who won?
The question is...
We two for two, baby. Two for two.
No.
Three.
Oh, yeah, you are two for two, actually.
That's crazy.
So the question is at hand. And this is what we're going to answer today. Okay. Why are females not comfortable walking into a barbershop? And you know what, Devin? You know what I'm uncomfortable about?
What?
I'm uncomfortable about y'all not choosing my question.
This is the second episode. If you guys choose question D, you might get my... No, you right there, the one that is actually driving and supporting our growth. Choose question B over question A. I'm uncomfortable with you.
But
we won this week.
He won this week, man. Why are females not comfortable walking into a barbershop? Let me hear it.
Well, I think females are not comfortable walking into a barbershop because y'all know what y'all talking about in salons. And y'all know men in the barbershop, that's when they're the most comfortable being themselves. They feel comfortable being able to talk about this, talk about that.
Absolutely.
And you might actually be afraid of what you might hear, what you might see, or... But actually, what the misconception is, we need y'all in the barbershop. Y'all opinion on our conversation does nothing but help move us forward. You know,
women opinions matter.
Oh, that's a
hashtag.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
So you telling me right now that they shouldn't be uncomfortable.
Welcome.
You know what? I just didn't think you was gonna go to this
route. He a hater.
I didn't.
I love them. I love the women.
I did not think you was gonna go this route. I didn't. But it's actually pretty interesting, to say the least. It's pretty interesting that you went this route. Pretty interesting. But I asked two or three of my clients, man, and you know, they told me that walking into a barbershop for them, it depends on what barbershop they walk into, who's in there, and also the location and environment. So as I analyze that, I'm thinking, okay, so the only reason why you feel uncomfortable is because you're walking into an environment that has you feeling degraded. You know what I'm saying? Like,
all eyes on me.
Even though both sides play a part. You know, I'm not one-sided. I'm actually on the fence. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sitting on the fence and one side can pull me over, the other side can pull me over. You know what I'm saying? I feel like the reason why females are uncomfortable is because of how they present themselves coming into a barbershop, and also the reason why females feel uncomfortable walking to a barbershop is because of the men that are in the barbershop gazing and, you know, kind of undressing females with their eyes. Just the type of environment.
Especially here in No Grease, we actually have most of our secretaries are women.
Right.
And I actually think that helps balance us out.
Yeah.
It helps keeps us calm and keeps us on task.
Yeah, definitely. Yes, sir. So this segment here is called Off the Top. God.
Get it.
Fresh braids.
Get you every time.
But this week, man, we are talking about one of our GOATs lined up. Nas, Illmatic, King's Disease. You know, we respect you, brother. This week, the quote or the lyric, I do not know where this came from, but, you know, it means a lot. It means a lot. The quote is, I'm capable of anything. My imagination can give me wings. How you feel about that?
Man, that's actually one of the primary questions I actually talk about with one of my customers every day. Mm. I like to talk about, like, what do you like to do in your spare time that is still, like, a creative outlet of yours?
Right.
What I found is, when with an adults, is we don't have any more creative outlets. You know, people are not working in their passions, they're working in their money. So what that quote means to me is that we stop believing that we are capable of everything, mm-hmm. because we put ourselves in a box,
right.
of what you're able to do. You can't spread your wings in a box. Mm-hmm. You need area out to find what you want to do and use those wings to carry you where you want to be. Mm-hmm. Wings to me simulate that you believe in yourself, that you trust that if you jump off this cliff that you'll be able to carry yourself and you won't fall down to the bottom. Mm.
Capable of anything.
Capable of anything. And I just want all the people listening to this and them know that you are capable of anything. I believe in you. Mm.
Shout out to our owner.
Shout out Ed. You know,
shout out to Ed.
Shout out
Dre. He's a big Nas fan. Shout out to Dre. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're big Nas fans. So, you know, we're going to take this and, you know, I'm going to let you guys know what this means to me. But, you know what I'm saying? I'm capable of anything. My imagination can give me wings.
What's that mean? I ain't gonna lie, you're one of the most creative people I've seen.
I feel like anything that somebody throws my way, mm-hmm. and I'm gonna say this just because I'm a barber, anything that somebody throws my way when it comes to a haircut, I can do. I've been in this game for 5-6 years and I've been cutting for probably almost 15-16, right? So with that being said, if you're not challenged to do something different than what you do on a daily basis, I don't feel like you're growing. Mm. So if it challenges me, then I'm able to do it. I feel like I'm capable of doing it. Now, when I put myself in the mindset of being capable of doing something, I feel like, you know, I'm free. I feel like I'm free. You know what I'm saying? Like, if somebody came in today and was like, yo, I want you to give me a haircut, but you're the artist. Do whatever you want. Just make me look good.
Oh, that's my favorite.
I love that quote.
I
love it. Because when that is said, you're like, damn, I get the wings to do whatever I want to do? Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Let me fly then.
I'm going to be out there.
Like, I'm a fly, and I'm a basically take care of this person, and I'm going to do any and everything I want just to make this person walk out of here and feel good about himself. Hmm. All right, man. Dev, last segment of the night
is
the barber pole.
Heaters.
Now, usually, Dev, on a regular basis, and this is what we've been doing in the past two episodes, we've been asking questions related to the barber game or just, you know, barbershop related.
But I'm a person. Are you a person?
I'm definitely a person. And when you come in here, what do we talk about? Do we talk about barbering?
They don't know.
No, they don't. I mean, with my clientele, I don't talk about barbering. We talk about everything else. And with everything else, questions are asked and answers are needed. You know what I'm saying? So, we got two questions for y'all. Can married men have female friends?
Hey,
question A.
Question B is, how do you balance your work life and your family life? Is one winning or is one suffering?
Yeah. Don't try to add a little extra seasoning on it just to make your question.
I can add it on.
Don't try to add extra seasoning to make your question feel all right, man. So people can choose you.
But thank y'all for coming for episode 3 of the Premium Lounge,
man. Like, comment, subscribe. Hopefully you guys tune in to our next episode so we can answer. Thank you. Thank you for tuning in, man. Again, my name is Devin.
I'm Devin. I'm
Devin. That's DC. My name is DC.
I'm Devin.
And this is the Premium Lounge.